Okay, on this question, they're giving us the angle theta is negative 7 pi over 6, and they're asking us to find the sine and the cosine of that angle. So I'm going to bring up us up to the unit circle here. Again, our angle is negative 7 pi over 6. So how do we deal with a negative angle? Well, let me show you two ways. First off, let's start at zero. This is 0 degrees, right? They decided to make zero straight to the right, so that's where we start. Okay, and 7 pi over 6 is right here. That's positive though. That's positive 7 pi over 6. So in other words, if we go from here to here, that is going to be positive because it goes up 7. Whatever, put it right in the middle, maybe. This is positive. That angle is positive 7 pi over 6 because it goes up from 0. So you start at 0, you go up 7 pi over 6, and around that opening, this amount, like if you opened a door really wide, like more than, that's really what. So if you opened a door, started here, and you opened it all the way past 180, even, that would be opening the door at an angle positive 7 pi over 6, which is also 210 degrees. Anyway, we're looking for negative. So how do you do negative? Well, you just do the same thing in the opposite direction. Now, in other words, if starting at 0, positive 7 pi over 6 means you go up and up. How far up? Halfway around, and then one more line. So then just do the same thing in the negative direction. So I'm going to go starting here, start going down halfway around, and one more line. Right there must be negative 7 pi over 6, which ends right here. That make sense? So we can say the sine of negative 7 pi over 6. Remember, it's right here is cosine. The first one's always cosine, the second one's always sine, right? So the sine of negative 7 pi over 6 would be a half, and the cosine of negative 7 pi over 6 is negative square root of 3 over 2. I'm just grabbing those right here. And you might say, wait, that's 5 pi over 6. Well, yeah, that's the same as positive 5 pi over 6. It's also negative 7 pi over 6. See how I did that? So positive angles, you start at 0 and you go up until you find it. Negative angles, you start at 0 and you go down and around until you find it. Well, how far do you go? Well, just find out how far to get to the positive one and do the same thing in the opposite direction for the negative one. So to get to positive 7 pi over 6 here, I had to go halfway around in one more line. There's positive 7 pi over 6. So just do the same thing in the negative direction. Go halfway around and one more line, which ends you at 150 or positive 5 pi over 6, which is the same as negative 7 pi over 6. And so there's your cosine and your sine. Cosine always comes first. Cosine is x and sine is y. And there's our answers. So that's one way. The other way is you could convert. So I think that's the best way. The other way is you could just convert your negative angle to a positive. You could just say, okay, I'm going to take my negative 7 pi over 6, and I'm just going to subtract it from 2 pi. I'm just going to subtract it from 2 pi. Because if you want to find a negative angle, it's going to be, think about degrees for a minute. If somebody said, I want to go negative 30 degrees, that'd be right there, right? Negative 30 degrees, one line. It's the same as positive 330. I don't know if you can see that. Let me get rid of that. Same as positive 330, right? Because if you just took 360 minus 30 degrees, you'd get three positive, whoops, 330 degrees. It's kind of scribbly. Sorry about that. There we go. Yeah, so my point is that negative 30 degrees is the same as positive 330. They're the same spot because it's 360 minus 30, right? Whenever you add or subtract 360, you end up at the same spot because that's spinning all the way around. So my point is I could take the 7 pi over 6 and just subtract it from all the way around 2 pi, right? If negative, so then, but that's a little hard. You put this over one common denominator, all this monkey business here, multiply top and bottom by 6, and you get 12 pi over 6. I don't think this is easier, but harder. Minus 7 pi over 6, and you get 5 pi over 6. Positive, which we already discovered, yeah, positive 5 pi over 6. That is the same spot as negative 7 pi over 6, right? Because negative 7 pi over 6 and positive 5 pi over 6, they end in the same spot because altogether they make a full circle. They make 360. They're the same spot. All right, so I'll give you two ways. I think the easiest way to do a negative angle is just to start at zero, go up and around until you find the positive angle, then just look at how far you went. What did I do? I went halfway and one more line. So then the negative, go the other direction, halfway, one more line. It's got to be right here at positive 5 pi over 6. That's the same as negative 7 pi over 6. If you don't like that, the other way is you could just subtract from 2 pi. And that'll give you the spot as well. Why is that right? Because you can always add or subtract a full circle. And so there we go. And we get the sine and the cosine by just first value is cosine, second value is sine.